With an increased global presence comes increased regulation and compliance. An increasing number of tax authorities are exploring advantages of digitalized invoicing and reporting system. 7 of the top 10 GDP countries have introduced or are planning to introduce mandatory e-invoices. SAP helps enterprises navigate these challenges by offering localized software solutions. SAP believes software localization enables customers to get value from their core business applications across geographies. How do we achieve this? SAP enables our customers to scale with confidence through the delivery of more than 1,000 local versions across the SAP product portfolio. Local versions comprise a set of localizations which we deliver as standard to enable you to do business compliantly in a specific country. Regulations continuously evolve. Compliance is not optional, and compliance achieved once is not compliance achieved forever. Through regulatory relief as a service, SAP enables our customers to adhere to new and evolving regulations affecting business processes. In 2023, we delivered more than 1,200 legal changes across our portfolio because of new and changing regulations in over 55 countries. Finally, we are transforming localized business processes by infusing business AI into localization use cases. Let me give you an example of what I mean. Every year, about 1.1 billion electronic documents are being exchanged with tax authorities in SAP document and reporting compliance. Now, if just 2% of those documents got errors from tax authorities, that would leave us 22 million documents with errors. Handling these errors can be tough, especially when they are difficult to understand. Let's meet John. John is a tax accountant responsible for e-document processing at Teach It Technologies and has to deal with a lot of errors being returned from tax authorities. Today he is working on one e-invoice with an error. Recipient goods and services taxpayer identification number state code does not match with the state code passed in the recipient details. John does not understand this error and is wondering what GST identification number state code is being used right now. Since the error message is not detailed enough to answer the question, John decides to check the invoice XML for additional details. Unfortunately, the XML is a bit too technical for an accountant like John. He does find 29, which is the recipient state code, and can also see the GSTIN number, which is very long. He cannot find the GSTIN state code mentioned in the error message, and John still cannot identify the problem. This is what John is struggling with today. Tomorrow, Joule is going to help John, offering easy-to-understand explanations, root cause insights, and guidance. Still the same e-invoice and the same error message. Except this time, John can ask Joule to explain the error message in this e-invoice. Joule first explains the tax authority rule. Turns out, GSTIN is a 15-digit code, and state code is simply the first 2 digits. Joule then pinpoints the real issue, which is that the buyer's GST starts with 33, but the buyer's state code is given as 29. Joule indicates this is a business partner master data error and asks John to contact the business partner specialist to check on this issue. Joule offers an option to know more. When John clicks on it, Joule shows John how to maintain the GSTIN number, which is what John was curious about. Joule also provides relevant SAP help links, and John feels much more confident about how this error should be handled. The benefits are tangible. Up to 90% reduction in time spent on understanding the error details and identifying the root cause to resolve the error.